Okay guys, we'll start with this topic today, posterior triangle of the neck. You all have been taught about the deep fascia of the neck. Deep fascia of the neck has a lot of modifications. I believe you must have studied by now. That has been taught. I'm seeing you chatting, so now tell me what a similarity you find between abdomen and neck. What similarity after like studying this much of head and neck, abdomen complete has been taught to you, what similarity you find between the abdomen and the neck? You see, both these, yes, anterior abdomen and neck, what is the similarity in abdomen, between abdomen and the neck? Abdomen and neck, both these portions of the body, they do not have any bony protection from the front. Like your head and neck has a bony thing, the face in front, then in the chest you have the rib cage, in the pelvis you have this bony pelvis, but this neck and abdomen, they don't have anything bony or protective anteriorly. So these two areas of the body, the neck and the abdomen, they have only muscles anteriorly. Got it? So both these areas, the deep fascia has a lot of modifications, or the superficial fascia or the deep fascia. You've been taught about the abdomen and the neck, that in the abdomen, if you remember, there was the superficial fascia, which was modified into fascia of camper, fascia of scarpa, and then what there was, the rectus sheath, the modification of the deep fascia there, the aponeurosis of the three muscles. And the rectus abdominis. So all these muscles and the fascia, they were actually only protective layer anteriorly in the abdomen. Now similarly in the neck also, you don't have any bony protection. Here also you have the strap muscles, the platysma, as well as the deep fascia. The deep fascia in the neck also has a modification. Another similarity between abdomen and neck is that these are the two portions of the spine. Here you find there is lordosis, anterior convexity in the neck and the abdominals. The neck, because that's why, you know, these two curvatures are called the secondary curvatures. Primarily the spine, complete spine from the cervical region to the coccyx. It is anteriorly concave. That's the fetal lying position. But as the newborn gradually grows, around 4 to 6 months, there is neck holding. If you lie the baby prone on the bed, she or he will try to raise or lift her head up. And there she starts developing this secondary curvature in the cervical spine, that is anterior convexity. Then this lumbar lordosis, this also is a secondary curvature. This starts developing when a baby starts to stand up. The infant starts to stand up around 1 year to 15 months. There's this development of secondary curvature in the spine in the lumbar region. So these were some similarities between the neck and the abdomen, and that's the reason you have more of flexion in these sides. Although these two sides are having anterior convexity in the spine, anterior convexity, but you find that in your regular life, you are flexing your neck and well as the abdomen anteriorly. And that's the advantage, because you don't have any bony thing anteriorly. You don't have a bony protection in the neck and the abdominals. So you have more span of flexion in the abdomen and the neck. And the cervical spine is like the most used spine in flexion. Okay. So that's how this, and you know, curvatures, of course, somebody has written, Akash, that intervertebral discs also play a major role in maintaining the curvature of the spine, especially in the lumbar region, where this intervertebral discs are more bulged anteriorly, maintaining this anterior convexity. Okay, so that was some, to bring up to this topic about the neck. So that's why I was telling this fascia, the deep fascia of the neck is called fascia coli, the Colles fascia. Colles fascia, you must have heard of in the pelvis also, the deep fascia of the scrotum, that also is Colles fascia. And the fascia of the neck is also Colles fascia. So that fascia has been divided into different groups, so in the neck, the deep fascia has a modifications like invests the muscles like sternocleidomastoid and trapezius. That's the outer layer, that's called the investing layer. Then you have pretracheal, prevertebral layer of the fascia. And the three, remember, carotid sheath is formed by the contribution from the three layers, investing layer, pretracheal, prevertebral, they all contribute to form the carotid sheath. And the buccopharyngeal, pharyngobasilar, and still other modifications. The tunnels for omohyoid, pulley for digastric, ligament of Berry, capsule of thyroid, axillary sheath, then space of Burr. Hello, are you all connected? Okay, this got disconnected somehow. Anyways, so that was just a revision of your past lectures. Now we'll focus upon the posterior triangle of the neck. This triangle, the posterior triangle, as the name suggests, it's actually a misnomer. First of all, it's a misnomer, because it's not seen in the posterior region of the neck. Rather, it is seen on the lateral side of the neck. Got it? So it's a posterior triangle, although seen on the lateral side of the neck. We are actually seeing now the neck from the lateral side. Okay? Okay, now, posterior triangle of the neck. Look here. This is the side of the neck. And in the side of the neck, when you look here, you'll actually find two triangles. This is the side of the neck. Side of the neck, it's bounded above by the base of the mandible, anterior midline, then it's the clavicle forming the floor and the sternum anteriorly, and the posterior boundary is formed by the anterior border of trapezius. So this side of the neck has been divided obliquely by this muscle, sternocleidomastoid. Now the sternocleidomastoid muscle, when it obliquely divides, then the anterior portion and the portion of the side of the neck anterior to the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid is called the anterior triangle. Got it? So the boundary of the anterior triangle, you can see, is anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid, base of the mandible, and the anterior midline. That's the anterior triangle. Although it has further subdivisions, which will be taught to you in other lecture. Now, this is the posterior triangle which we're going to study right now. This triangle, you can see the boundaries here. The posterior boundary of this posterior triangle of the neck, anterior boundary of the posterior triangle of the neck is formed by the posterior border of sternocleidomastoid. And the posterior boundary, is formed by the anterior border of trapezius. The apex is formed where the two muscles meet, the sternocleido and the trapezius, at the superior nuchal line, and the floor or the base of the triangle is formed by the middle one third of the clavicle. Sternocleidomastoid actually has two origins: a sternal head, which is tendinous, and a clavicular head, which is muscular. So both the heads blend together and there are obliquely an insert in the mastoid and the superior nuchal line. So that's why the base is actually not completely sharp triangular because of the fleshy head of the sternocleidomastoid. So these are the boundaries. Hope you remember, you learned these boundaries, because I suppose if there is a question on this posterior triangle, it can be of 5 to 6 marks, or it can reach even up to 10 marks if it gets associated with the details about the structures underlying and the clinical aspects. Then it can even be extended to 10 marks. Okay. Now, this again is the same diagram. So you can observe the triangles. This muscle, as I told you, has two heads. This is the sternal head, this is the clavicular head. Both of them merge and they ascend upwards behind the ear to reach the mastoid and the superior nuchal line. This is sternocleidomastoid. Now this is trapezius. Trapezius also arises there from this superior nuchal line, descends down and reaches to the clavicle, acromion, and the spine of scapula. The space in between this post blue color boundary, you're seeing the diagram. The blue color line, this defines the boundaries of the posterior triangle. The floor is formed by the middle one third of the clavicle. The green color margin they've outlined is the anterior triangle. Okay. Now the divisions of the posterior triangle, this posterior triangle has further been subdivided. Anterior triangle also has been further divided, which will be a next topic. But right now, you know, this posterior triangle, you know, they have been divided by an inferior belly of omohyoid, which divides this posterior triangle into two parts. The upper part is a larger part, and that's called the occipital triangle. A smaller part, the lower part, is known as the supraclavicular or the subclavian or the omoclavicular triangle. You will see that this is the posterior triangle. I taught you about the boundaries here. Now, this triangle has been divided by this muscle, which has two bellies, a superior belly and an inferior belly, with an intervening tendon in between. So this omohyoid, you know, it takes origin from the superior border of the scapula, just medial to the superior suprascapular notch. This is the inferior belly of omohyoid, and the superior belly reaches to the hyoid bone. The two bellies have a tendon in between. Now, to maintain this obliquity of omohyoid, there is a fascial tunnel. There's a fascial tunnel below to the sternocleidomastoid. Remember that this omohyoid passes behind the sternocleidomastoid or deep to the sternocleidomastoid. So omohyoid, this angulation is maintained because of the modification of deep fascia makes a tunnel, which binds this tendon below to the sternocleidomastoid. That's how this has an obliquity, this muscle, you know, omohyoid. Now the inferior belly of omohyoid is seen in the posterior triangle. This inferior belly of omohyoid divides this triangle into upper larger portion. This upper larger portion is called the occipital triangle. However, the lower smaller triangle, you can see above to the middle one third of the clavicle, this triangle is the subclavian triangle, because you know subclavian vessels pass out from here. Or it can even be called as supraclavicular triangle. Okay, or omoclavicular, because it's between omohyoid and clavicle, so omoclavicular triangle. Okay. Now about the roof of the triangle, you know, the side of the, it's like from the side of the neck. So side of the neck, what will be the structures one by one, superficial to deep? If you see, first of all, it is formed by the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. Okay. The roof actually it's not from superficial to deep. If you go, it will be the skin first, right? Then first of all, it will be the skin, then the superficial fascia, and then the contents of superficial fascia, and then it will be the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. So superficial to this deep layer of the investing layer, you will find platysma, which is a subcutaneous muscle. It again, it's a muscle of the facial expression that has been taught to you. Develops from the second pharyngeal arches, nerves of in the superficial fascia. Then parts, this internet connection is having a little bit problems. Then parts of supraclavicular, great auricular, transverse cutaneous, lesser occipital nerves. These are the cutaneous nerves of the neck. They will also be found in the roof of the posterior triangle. There were various unnamed arteries derived from the occipital artery, transverse cervical, and suprascapular artery. Now, these unnamed branches supply the skin of the side of the neck. There will be lymph vessels which pierce the deep fascia to enter into the supraclavicular nodes. Now, the vessels lying in the subsuperficial fascia of the side of the neck, obviously, the supraclavicular lymph nodes are the deep lymph nodes. So these lymphatics, they will pierce the deep fascia to drain into the supraclavicular nodes. Okay. In this diagram, you are seeing is a cut section of the neck. So in the cut section, what you're seeing from periphery is this is skin. Then you have a superficial fascia, this yellow color. Then is the green color thing, that's a deep fascia, the fascia coli, and that splits to include sternocleidomastoid mastoid anteriorly, and it splits to include trapezius posteriorly. So this outer layer is the investing layer. There is a layer of fascia which invests, which runs anterior to trachea and anterior to the thyroid gland. Now this is pretracheal fascia. It extends below down into the superior mediastinum and blends with the arch of aorta. In this way, this pretracheal fascia also helps to maintain the convexity or the curvature of the arch of aorta by pulling it up. So this is pretracheal fascia, and pretracheal also forms the capsule of the thyroid gland. One of its modification is ligament of Berry. Then, this fascia anterior to the prevertebral muscles, this is prevertebral fascia. One of the modifications of prevertebral fascia is axillary sheath, right? Then the major vessels, the internal jugular and common or internal carotid, they're in, and the vagus, they are enclosed, the vitals, they're enclosed within this sheath derived from prevertebral investing layer and pretracheal. Together they form this carotid sheath. Then there are lymph nodes behind this pretracheal fascia. In this space, it's the retropharyngeal lymph nodes. I'll not go so much in deep because you'll get confused. This topic has also already been taught to you. What I want to tell you is, because the topic today is sternocleidomastoid as well as the posterior triangle. So first you see that this muscle here, the sternocleidomastoid, superficial to deep, what will be the superficial relations? You can see a superficial fascia. Then you have this platysma in the superficial fascia. And in the superficial fascia, you also find this external jugular vein. And on the side of the external jugular vein, you'll find is superficial cervical lymph nodes, right? And there are four cutaneous nerves which supply the skin of the side of the or anterior cutaneous nerve. Then middle supraclavicular nerve, although there are three supraclavicular nerve, you have a lateral, intermediate, and a medial supraclavicular nerve, and a lesser occipital nerve. These are the cutaneous nerves running in the superficial fascia. And remember that parotid gland also is in the superficial fascia. It is outside the investing layer. Down below, although the investing layer covers this parotid gland to form the capsule of the parotid gland, it invests the submandibular gland as well, and it forms the space of burn. So there are also a lot of modifications in the investing layer. Keep reading, because it might be, you know, whatever if I'm saying, you know, I keep connecting past topics so that you keep on recapitulating the past topics which have been taught. This is only helpful if you are regularly studying. Then this is space, you know, this is trapezius. So anterior border of the trapezius, and this is sternocleidomastoid, the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid. This is space here is actually forming the roof of the posterior triangle. This space here is actually the posterior triangle. So what you conclude that the floor of the posterior triangle is formed by the prevertebral fascia, and the roof is formed by the investing layer. This space here is the posterior triangle, and the floor, the muscles lying in the floor, you know, you can see these are the trunks of the brachial plexus. And if you remember the first initial classes in the upper limb, if you remember that the roots of the brachial plexus, they emerge between two muscles. So this will be sclenius anterior and this is sclenius medius. So in between sclenius anterior and sclenius medius, you find these trunks of the brachial plexus. Got it? So from here, they will reach here in the posterior triangle. Okay. Then sclenius medius, and then down below, you'll have levator scapulae and splenius capitis. They'll all also be forming the floor of the posterior triangle, which you'll see in other diagrams. Because now we are concerned with the roof. So roof means, you know, structures, you know, in the roof is like, you know, when you remove the skin, actually, though it's not actually under, rather the structures under the skin of the roof. So in this diagram, these structures are actually the contents of the roof of the posterior triangle. Once again, you see this is the sternocleidomastoid, this is trapezius, this is space, is the posterior triangle. Now focus on this blue color thing. This blue color is actually the external jugular vein. And I told you that one of the major contents of the roof of the posterior triangle is external jugular vein. Now, external jugular vein, remember the blood supply of face has been taught to you. This actually, there's a vein running down here in the front of the ear or the tragus of the ear, which forms by superficial temporal and maxillary vein. When they join to form the retromandibular vein, it divides into anterior and posterior division. The posterior division, now this is the posterior division of retromandibular vein and the posterior auricular vein together joined to form external jugular vein. Now, external jugular vein runs in the roof of the posterior triangle. It receives various tributaries, posterior external jugular vein, anterior jugular vein, transverse cervical vein, suprascapular vein, and there's an oblique vein also. So there are various tributaries to this external jugular vein. Remember, it is running in the superficial fascia. But ultimately, when it's running in the superficial fascia, it will have to drain into the deep vein, right? So all the structures, Ranjan Yadav, Samaj Dhyan, the Suntero, you know, this is like, you know, when we start communicating, the topic gets distracted. Instead of like talking right now, you just stay here. Whatever I'm saying, you listen. So this is this external jugular vein. All the structures you're seeing, main or most of them, they are all the contents of the roof of the posterior triangle. So lying in the superficial fascia. as I was saying, that is a superficial vein, it will have to pierce the deep fascia to enter and, or rather the drain into the subclavian vein, because subclavian now is a deep vein. So just above the clavicle, the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia, you know, when it reaches to the base of the neck, anteriorly, you know, it is the manubrium, sternae, and the two sides, it's the first rib, and anterior to them is the clavicle. So the investing layer, when it reaches the suprasternal border, it splits to enclose the anterior and posterior borders, upper borders of the manubrium, and the space enclosed is called space of Bern or suprasternal space of Bern. What are the contents of suprasternal space of Bern? There are three contents of the suprasternal space of Bern. Can anybody tell the three contents of the yes, interclavicular ligament, very good, Akash. Then there are suprasternal lymph nodes, and there will be an jugular venous arch. No, head of sternocleidomastoid is not a content of this space of, you know, Bern. Yes, so jugular venous arch, interclavicular ligament, and the suprasternal lymph nodes. Okay. So that was one modification. The other is that the deep fascia on the side of the neck, when it reaches down to the clavicle, it also splits, and it splits to blend with there on the capsule, on the clavicle, as well as the first rib. Then there, you know, at the base of the neck, this external jugular vein, which pierces the deep fascia, the investing layer, to drain into the subclavian vein. Now, important point here is this, they have focused it, that's why in this diagram, they have zoomed it out. Look here, this is external jugular vein. When it reaches, when it pierces the deep fascia, the investing layer, to drain down into the subclavian vein. Okay. So what happens, you know, the three layers of any vessel is tunica intima, tunica media, and outer layer is tunica adventitia. So it's a fibrous layer on the outer wall of any vessel, either artery, vein, or lymphatics. Tunica adventitia is the outer layer. And the investing layer and the deep fascia is also it's a fibrous tissue, dense fibrous connective tissue. So when there are always like fibrous tissue comes in close approximation, they blend and they join actually. So what happening is here, there's important clinical point attached with this, that this external jugular vein, when it pierces the deep fascia, the margins get attached or tethered or blends with the deep fascia. So what happens is, in case of like, you know, any nick in the neck, like it might be during shaving, or might be like some people, like, you know, when they threat by, you know, attempting suicide by placing a knife on the side of the neck, you must have seen in the movies. They keep a knife on the side of the neck and they threaten of suicide. So if there is a slight cut on the side of the neck, you know, this vein is a superficial vein running in this superficial fascia in the side of the neck. If this vein gets sliced, it gets sliced or it gets cut, what will happen? There will be a profuse bleeding. There will be not death. It's not a systemic vein, it's a superficial vein. So there will be profuse bleeding. So when there will be profuse bleeding, the importance lies here. That's why I told you, because there will be profuse bleeding, like you can go for a bandage, you can compress the vein, but you'll find that the oozing out of the blood will not stop easily. And the reason is that the vein cannot compress or constrict or collapse because its margins are attached with the fascia. The vein stays open. Now this portion which is deeper to this deep fascia draining into the subclavian vein, this doesn't collapse, so you know this is a systemic vein. There will be oozing of blood, and the subclavian vein drains into the thorax. You know, it forms, it drains into the brachiocephalic vein, and that it drains into the SVC and into the right atrium. So, and all this channel, one important point about this external jugular vein also, another important point is that right, you know, external jugular vein drains into the subclavian, subclavian drains into the brachiocephalic, and brachiocephalic into superior vena cava, and superior vena cava into the right atrium. Got it? The entire channel I told you is valveless. Very important. It's valveless. So the pressure, the intra-atrial pressure, the intra-atrial pressure of the right atrium is reflected here in the external jugular vein. It's one of the clinical points. You have to, you know, it will be taught, and it should be taught in your medicine clinical postings. And even you're taught to examine this, and this is called JVP, jugular venous pressure. You need two scales to monitor it, like you have to bend the neck. And then you'll need a horizontal and a vertical placement of the scale over this suprasternal notch, and you'll have to observe the venous pressure here. And that venous pressure actually signifies the intra-atrial pressure from the right atrium. So in one clinical point related with external jugular vein is that it is it has a connection to the right atrium right away. There is no walls in between, so it reflects the intra-atrial pressure from the right atrium. Then we are back to here. So because the heart is directly communicating without walls, so blood will keep on oozing. So it's an emergency. What can be done is you need to give another nick on the side of the vein. So if you release this vein from the adjoining deep fascia, it will collapse, and that's how after, you know, you'll have to release this pressure. So there it can, you know, prevent further bleeding after suturing the vein. And, you know, first of all, you'll have to release the pressure from outside, which is pulling this vein from surrounding. So you have to nick or incise this deep fascia to make it compress. Okay. So this was because it's like, you know, the thorax, I told you, is normally having a negative intrathoracic pressure. And that's the reason for passive inhalation, because of the negative intrathoracic pressure. So another important point is because of the negative intrathoracic pressure, and the vein is not able to collapse, and there is a nick here. So not only bleeding, but the air with each inspiration, air will be sucked in from this external jugular vein, and that embolus of air will reach to the heart. So that's called air embolism. Okay. So many points you have collected with external jugular vein. You remember, these are the few points you can highlight in your exam, long questions. If you have been asked a long question of around 10 marks, you have to mention about each of these clinical points, that external jugular vein is also, when sliced and what's, because of its attachment to the fascia, it can lead to air embolism, profuse bleeding. Then it also helps to determine jugular venous pressure, JVP. Abdul Samad, ye sab cheeze humne nahi boli hain, to CABG ki baatein nahi karte, theek hai? CABG mein ye nahi use karte. You will have, you know, deep, you know, internal jugular vein, theek hai? Internal jugular vein is used, that's a wider caliber vein, which is deep inside. Theek hai, to jo hum bolte ja rahe hain, us pe dhyan do abhi. तो ये हो गया वेनस के बारे में. नाउ लुक हियर, अभी रूफ के हम कंटेंट्स की बात कर रहे हैं. नाउ दिस पोस्टीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ स्टर्नो क्लीडो मैस्टोइड हैज अ लॉट ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस एट इट मिड पॉइंट. सो एट द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ द पोस्टीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ द स्टर्नो क्लीडो मैस्टोइड द वेरियस क्यूटेनियस नर्व्स इमर्जिंग आउट. Now look here, there you find is the floor of the triangle. And I told you that the floor of the triangle, these are, you know, the muscles here are sclerenius medius, then you have, you know, splenius anterior will be there, you know, it will be partly seen there, then splenius levator scapulae, then you know, splenius medius, levator scapulae, then you have, you know, splenius capitis, ठीक है. तो ये मसल्स हैं. अब ये सब प्रीवर्टिब्रल मसल, दे विल बी कवर्ड बाय प्रीवर्टिब्रल फाशा, ठीक. नाउ दीज यू नो सर्वाइकल प्लेक्सस आल्सो इज देयर व्हिच इज बीनीथ द प्रीवर्टिब्रल फाशा. सो इंपॉर्टेंस इज दैट दीज नर्व्स व्हेन दे रीच द रूफ ऑफ द posterior triangle, they will actually pierce two fascia. Remember now, the cutaneous nerve, first of all, they will pierce the prevertebral fascia to arise there at the midpoint of the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are muscles. We'll not talk about the spinal accessory because this is a deep nerve which is running below the prevertebral fascia. We are talking about the four cutaneous nerves. So they first pierce the prevertebral fascia, then they arise, you know, in the superficial fascia. But before reaching to the superficial fascia, they will have to pierce the deep fascia. Okay. तो पहले तो ये prevertebral fascia को pierce करेंगे, उसके बाद investing layer of the deep fascia को pierce करेंगे, फिर बन जाएंगे contents of the superficial fascia. Now you'll see कि इसमें branches क्या क्या हैं. This one is the great auricular nerve. This great auricular nerve, it ascends up. Let me tell you that it is the largest ascending branch of cervical plexus. Great auricular nerve, it ascends up. It is C2, C3 ventral rami. It divides into anterior and posterior divisions and supplies the skin on the angle of mandible, over the parotid and the ear lobule, anteriorly or laterally, or lateral supply of the pinna in the lower one third. There will be a posterior division which will supply the ear lobule posteriorly. ठीक है, अभी इस पे ज्यादा ध्यान नहीं देते हैं क्योंकि this will be better seen in the other diagrams. Then you have this another nerve which runs along. अगर पूछा जाए which cutaneous nerve ascends over to sternocleidomastoid, over the surface of sternocleidomastoid, that is great auricular. Another point is that it is the largest ascending branch. There's another nerve that's great, that this one is lesser occipital nerve. Now lesser occipital nerve is also derived from C2 ventral rami. ठीक है, वेंट्रल रमाई ऑफ C2, इट एसेंड्स बिहाइंड द ईयर, इट सप्लाइज द स्किन ओवरलाइंग द मेस्टोइड प्रोसेस, इट सप्लाइज द स्किन ऑन द मीडियल और द टेम्पोरल सरफेस ऑफ द पिन्ना इन अपर टू थर्ड. ओके, देन हु विल टेल मी द नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द अपर टू थर्ड ऑफ द पिन्ना on its lateral surface? Who will tell me the nerve supply on the upper two-third on the lateral surface of the pinna? Nerve supply of face karaya ja chuka hai. No, it's not posterior auricular, Ankita. Auricular nerve is a branch of facial nerve, that is motor nerve. Great auricular nerve to abhi bataya hai, great auricular nerve bataya hai, it supplies the ear lobule both anterior and posteriorly. Ayush, central venous line pe kyun piche pad gaya? Ayush Porwal, central venous cannulation sab bataya hai, ye internal jugular ke level ki baat hai, we are focusing on external jugular abhi padha rahe the. That's a deep vein. फेशियल की ब्रांचेस मोटर सप्लाई करती हैं, मोटर नर्व संजना. यहां पे हेड एंड नेक में सेंसरी और मोटर का बड़ा ध्यान रखना है. ठीक है, सो इट इज ऑरिकुलो शैल्वी. ओके, शैल्वी सोरियम सन्नी, इट्स ऑरिकुलो टेम्पोरल शिटिस. सो इट इज ऑरिकुलर टेम्पोरल, याद रखना है पिन्ना की जो सप्लाई है वो अपर टू थर्ड में, लेटरल सर्फेस इसको कहते हैं जो बाहर दिखता है, ठीक है। तो लेटरल आउटर सर्फेस अपर टू थर्ड इज ऑरिकुलर टेम्पोरल, लोअर वन थर्ड दैट इज ईयर लोब्यूल बोथ एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टली इज ऑरिकुलर टेम्पोरल, एंड पोस्टीरियर और द मीडियल, पोस्टीरियर मीडियल और टेम्पोरल सर्फेस ऑफ द पिन्ना पोस्टीरियरली अपर टू थर्ड इज बाय लेसर ऑक्सीपिटल। ओके, देन वाइंडिंग आउट लाइक फ्रॉम द मिड पॉइंट एंटीरियरली इन क्रॉसिंग दिस स्टर्नोफ्लुइडोमास्टॉइड इट रन्स एंटीरियरली टू सप्लाई द स्किन ऑफ द नेक एंटीरियरली, दिस इज ट्रांसवर्स क्यूटेनियस नर्व। ट्रांसवर्स क्यूटेनियस नर्व तो नाम से दिख रहा है ये ट्रांसवर्सली चलेगी, एंड इट विल सप्लाई द स्किन हियर, इट विल परफोरेट द डीप फाशिया एंड देन रन इन द सुपरफिशियल फाशिया टू सप्लाई द स्किन of the front of the neck below the mandible below the chin and the front of the neck up till the upper border of the sternum, clear hai? So that's transverse cutaneous nerve, iska dusra naam hai anterior cutaneous nerve, theek hai? Then there are supraclavicular nerves. Now supraclavicular nerves are actually three in number. सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व्स जो होते हैं ये C3, C4, वेंट्रल रमाई से अराइज करते हैं। नाउ दिस सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व्स दे डिवाइड इनटू मीडियल, इंटरमीडिएट एंड लेटरल ब्रांचेस। ठीक, सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व द मीडियल वन, द मीडियल डिवीजन सप्लाई द स्किन ऑन द साइड ऑफ द नेक एज वेल एज द फ्रंट ऑफ द चेस्ट, the skin overlying manubrium sternae, याद रखना the skin overlying manubrium sternae above the sternal angle will be innervated by medial branch of supraclavicular nerve. Then there is an intermediate branch. Intermediate branch of supraclavicular nerve, this will also supply it, this actually descends down, and if you remember एक इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है इंटरमीडिएट सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व के बारे में, कोई बता देगा एनीबॉडी फास्ट एन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट रिलेटेड विद इंटरमीडिएट सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व? ये सबसे पहले जो बोन पढ़ाई गई थी याद करो क्लाविकल, उसके पिक्यूलियर पॉइंट्स में दिया था दैट क्लाविकल, यस अभिषेक सिंह, इट इज ओकेजनली फाउंड दैट क्लाविकल इज पियर्स्ड बाय, इट इज पियर्स्ड बाय इंटरमीडिएट, occasionally found नहीं है दीपा कुंदू, it is always there but it is occasionally seen to pierce the clavicle, ठीक है। ये जो मंजीत कुमार पूछ रहे auricular temporal nerve damage हो जाती है, हमने अभी बात नहीं करी उसके बारे में, ठीक है, ज्यादा आगे आगे मत पढ़ो, ये free syndrome की बात करना चाह रहे हैं, अभी नहीं कर रहे हैं इसके बारे में, we'll talk about it later, ठीक है, सारी चीजें कंफ्यूज कर जाओगे, जितना हम बोल रहे हैं उस पर ध्यान दो, ठीक, विल डिस्कस अबाउट दैट लेटर ऑन। देन मिडिल इंटरमीडिएट सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व डिसेंड्स डाउन एंड सप्लाइज द फ्रंट ऑफ द सॉरी लेटरल साइड ऑफ द नेक, इट पियर्सेस ओकेजनली पियर्सेस द क्लाविकल एंड इट सप्लाइज द स्किन, याद रखना स्किन ऑफ द फर्स्ट इंटरकॉस्टल स्पेस, बहुत अच्छे से याद रखना दैट द स्किन ऑफ द फर्स्ट इंटरकॉस्टल स्पेस इज सप्लाइड बाय इंटरमीडिएट सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व, बता दिया बात याद रखना, ठीक, बिकॉज यू नो बहुत बार मैंने एक एम्ब्रियो का डायग्राम बनाते हैं डेवलपमेंट ऑफ लिम्बर्ट्स के बारे में, वहां पे बताया था दैट द स्टर्न द प्लेन द हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन पासिंग थ्रू द स्टर्नल एंगल, याद करो हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन पासिंग थ्रू द स्टर्नल एंगल, इट ट्रांसवर्सली कट्स द डेल्टॉइड इनटू अपर एंड लोअर हाफ्स, सो द स्किन अबव द स्टर्नल एंगल इज ऑल इनर्वेटेड बाय C3 C4 एंड द स्किन ऑन द बॉडी ऑफ स्टर्नम इज इनर्वेटेड बाय T2, पहले भी रिवाइज करा चुके थे, सो देयर आर मिसिंग डर्माटोम्स, याद आ रहा है सर, तो फर्स्ट रिप तो भाई ऊपर आ जाती है, ठीक है, और फर्स्ट रिप सॉरी फर्स्ट इंटरकॉस्टल स्पेस की जो कवरिंग स्किन है वो intermediate supraclavicular nerves hai. Now the lateral supraclavicular nerve, remember the lateral supraclavicular nerve will have a more oblique course. It will run on the side of the neck, will supply the skin there. It will, iske important point kya hai, the lateral supraclavicular nerve will supply the skin covering acromion. It will supply the skin covering coracoid. It will supply the skin overlying the upper half of deltoid. सब याद आ रहा है? ये सब देखो, जो मेरे लेक्चर्स को फॉलो कर पाएगा, जो रेगुलर पढ़ता रहता है, ध्यान से सुनता रहता है, सो ये सब बताया जा चुका है. तो रेजिमेंटल एरिया क्या होता है, कोई बता देगा? व्हाट इज रेजिमेंटल एरिया ऑन द स्किन ऑफ द बॉडी? रेजिमेंटल एरिया इज द स्किन कवरिंग the lower half of the deltoid and the nerve supply. Yes, lower half of the deltoid. The nerve supply of the lower skin covering the lower half of the deltoid is by Osama. You correct. Axillary nerve. Good. Okay, sorry, I'm sunny. Axillary nerve supplies the skin in the on the lower half of the deltoid. अब पूछा जाए स्किन नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द स्किन कवरिंग द अपर हाफ ऑफ द डेल्टॉइड, तो क्या आएगा आंसर? इट इज लेटरल सुप्रा क्लेविकुलर नर्व. ठीक. अगर पूछा जाए व्हाट इज द नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द समिट ऑफ शोल्डर, समिट ऑफ शोल्डर मींस द हाईएस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द शोल्डर, तो क्या आंसर होगा? लेटरल सुप्रा क्लेविकुलर नर्व. डर्माटोम क्या होगा? हु विल टेल मी? डर्माटोम ऑफ द स्किन skin covering the summit of shoulder. What is the dermatome? Yes, Shejal, C4. ये इसलिए भी बहुत important है क्योंकि diaphragm का referred pain, remember, goes to the left or right shoulders, phrenic nerve की वजह से. ठीक है, तो इसलिए बहुत important है इसका dermatome of both shoulders is C4 and phrenic nerve is C3, C4, C5. तो C4 का जो रिफर्ड पेन होता है वो समिट ऑफ शोल्डर्स पे होता है. ठीक. काफी सारी बातें हमने करी रिगार्डिंग दिस क्यूटेनियस नर्व्स. रिमेंबर सर्वाइकल प्लेक्सस गिव्स ग्रेट ऑरिकुलर, लेसर ऑक्सीपिटल, ट्रांसवर्स क्यूटेनियस एंड सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व्स. ठीक, ये बातें पता चली. इसमें ये सब C2 वाली है, C2 C3 ग्रेट ऑरिकुलर, ट्रांसवर्स क्यूटेनियस C2 C3 और लेसर ऑक्सीपिटल इज C2 ओनली एंड सुप्राक्लाविकुलर नर्व्स क्या है? C3 C4 ऑल फ्रॉम वेंट्रल डिविजन्स. दूसरा इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट दे पियर्स टू फाशिया. इनिशियली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे विल पियर्स द प्री वर्टिब्रल फाशिया, उसके बाद ये क्यूटेनियस बनने के लिए दे विल पियर्स द इन्वेस्टिंग लेयर. गॉट इट? सो इन द कोर्स दे विल पियर्स टू फाशिया. देन there is another cutaneous nerve which is not from the cervical plexus. Important point here, this is not this great occipital nerve you are seeing. It supplies the skin on the back of the head in the occipital region. Now this is great occipital nerve, this is C3, but this is from the dorsal primary ramus. Theek hai, to ye break cervical plexus ka part nahi hai and it pierces trapezius to emerge great occipital nerve. So that was all about, so also relevant important things about the structures in the roof of the side of the neck bata diya hai, skin covering the posterior triangle. Now external jugular vein ke bare mein short mein kafi sari cheeze hum bata dete hain, just keep revising. Now if you ask external jugular vein is formed by, kaise bataoge? It will form by the union of the anterior division, the posterior division of the retromandibular vein and posterior auricular vein. Ye dono milti hain, then it forms the external jugular vein, and because it's a superficial content of superficial fascia, it rests in the roof of the posterior triangle. It crosses the sternocleidomastoid vertically, or you can say obliquely. Then actually the muscle is oblique, the vein is vertical. It descends down, और फिर इसके बारे में तो बहुत डिटेल में बता दिया था that it pierces the investing layer of the fascia to drain into the subclavian vein where it blends the unica adventitia blends with the deep fascia and it gets tethered to the deep fascia. ये जो डॉटेड लाइन से क्यूटेनियस नर्व्स क्यों दिख रही हैं? डॉटेड लाइंस का क्या मतलब है? डॉटेड लाइंस का ये मतलब नहीं है कि दे आर डीपर टू स्टेनोक्लियर मास्टॉइड. डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज्ड. These all are cutaneous nerves. They're running in the roof, but they should be dotted. They are all running, superficial to the sternocleidomastoid mastoid. But because they are still below the deep fascia, so ye dekho, ye openings hain, ye openings hain, ye openings hain. That means, as I told you, ye pehle to prevertebral fascia ko pierce karke content bane hain posterior triangle ke. But they emerge in the roof after piercing these. Openings in the superficial fascia, in the piercing the deep investing layer to become cutaneous nerves. यहाँ पे देखो venous drainage of face कराया था, ठीक है, याद करो. ये facial vein किसे कहते हैं? Facial vein is formed by the union of supratrochlear, supraorbital, then it's called angular, which continues as facial. फेशियल वेन की एक ब्रांच होती है डीप फेशियल वेन, वो पीछे चली जाती है, टेरिगॉइड वेनस फ्लेक्सर से जुड़ती है. फिर ये कान के आगे क्या हो रहा था? ये एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड आर्टरी की ब्रांचेस के साथ साथ, रिमेम्बर, सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल मैक्सिलरी वेन टुगेदर कंटिन्यू एज व्हेन द टू वेन ज्वाइन, सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल एंड मैक्सिलरी वेन ज्वाइन टू फॉर्म रेट्रोमैंडिबुलर वेन. देन रेट्रोमैंडिबुलर वेन डिवाइड्स इनटू एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर डिवीजन. Anterior division of retromandibular vein joins the facial vein to form common facial vein, and common facial vein drains into internal jugular vein. ध्यान से रखना, याद रखना इस बात को, ठीक? फिर posterior division of retromandibular vein joins the posterior auricular vein to form the external jugular vein. External jugular vein drains into subclavian vein. ये W shaped figure जो है, ये बहुत important है, ठीक? और एक और इंपॉर्टेंट बाइट थी वेनस ड्रेनेज ऑफ हेड एंड नेक में, याद करो. दैट डीप इनसाइड द क्रैनी कैविटी वाज अ कैवर्नस साइनस, एंड दिस कैवर्नस साइनस वाज कम्युनिकेटिंग आउटसाइड टू द स्कल विद द हेल्प ऑफ इमिशरी वेन्स. तो कैवर्नस साइनस इज कम्युनिकेटिंग थ्रू टू द, यू नो, दिस इज टेरिकॉइड वेनस फ्लेक्सस थ्रू द इमिशरी वेन्स. इसी की वजह से बताया था डेंजरस एरिया ऑफ फेस कौन पर. हाँ, यह सही आकाश, सही है. इफ यू आर कैचिंग माई फ्रीक्वेंसी यू विल क्रैश वेरी इजिली एंड यू विल कीप यू नो आंसरिंग. सो टेरिगॉइड वेनस फ्लेक्सस से जो ड्रेनेज है, दैट्स वाई यू नो ये डेंजरस एरिया होता है. डेंजरस एरिया कहां पे होता है, कोई जल्दी से बता दे. यस, नोज, अपर लिप एंड टिप ऑफ लोअर पोर्शन ऑफ द नोज एंड अपर लिप्स, गॉट इट. सो उसका इंफेक्शन अंदर जा सकता है. Now look here, यही चीजें हम यहाँ पे बता रहे थे डेंजरस एरिया से रिलेटेड थी, क्योंकि क्या है यहाँ पे तो ऑर्बिट्स थे, राइट? सो ऑर्बिट से एक वेन पास होती है, सुपीरियर ऑफ्थैल्मिक वेन, ठीक है? अभी ये तुम्हें ऑस्टियोलॉजी नहीं पढ़ाई गई है, रिमेंबर, ये तुम्हारा, इफ यू हैव सीन दिस वॉल्यूम 3 ऑफ योर चौरसिया, तो द फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट्स द ऑस्टियोलॉजी दैट इंक्लूड्स द head, I mean that includes the skull, the manus, including the mandible and the cervical vertebrae. That's like a big chapter and lots of questions come from that. So orbits mein ek fissure hota hai, superior orbital fissure, theek hai? To usse superior orbital fissure ke ek upper or lateral portion hota hai, ek inferior or lower portion hota hai. To upper portion se ek vein pass hoti hai, superior ophthalmic vein, और वो क्रेनियम में जाके इनसाइड इट ड्रेन्स इनटू द कैवर्नस साइनस, गॉट इट? देन यू हैव इनफीरियर ऑफ्थैल्मिक वेन, ये भी सुपीरियर ऑर्बिटल फिशर से पास होती है लोअर पोर्शन से, एंड इट ड्रेन्स इनटू द टेरिगॉइड वेनस फ्लेक्सस. एंड टेरिगॉइड एंड कैवर्नस दे आर कम्युनिकेट, दिस इज आउटसाइड द क्रेनियल कैविटी, दिस इज इनसाइड द क्रेनियल कैविटी, दे हैव अ कम्युनिकेशन बाय लॉट्स ऑफ इमिशरी वेन्स, ठीक है? और इस वजह से ये वाला एरिया भी लोग सिर्फ इसको कहते हैं, बट रिमेंबर इवन फ्रॉम द आईज, ये आईज का वेनस ड्रेनेज भी अंदर ही जा रहा है, ठीक है, डायरेक्ट कैवर्नस साइनस में, बट वो फेस के अंदर नहीं आता, वो डीप इनसाइड हो जाता है, तो फेस पे इतना एरिया बोलते हैं. दे ड्रेन इनटू द डीप थ्रू द डीप फेशियल वेन, ये डीप फेशियल वेन के थ्रू कैवर्नस में जा रहा है. सो दैट्स हाउ अबाउट यू नो दिस डेंजरस एरिया. नाउ लुक हियर, ये है रेट्रोमैंडिबुलर ओए, इसमें एंटीरियर डिवीजन है, ये फेशियल वेन है, ये कॉमन फेशियल वेन ड्रेन्स इनटू द इंटरनल जुगलर. नाउ द पोस्टीरियर डिवीजन ये चला गया और ये जुड़ जाएगा पोस्टीरियर ऑरिकुलर से, जुड़ के बना लेगा एक्सटर्नल जुगलर वेन. अच्छा ये एक बात और बताओ, ये यू सीइंग एक्चुअली ये टेरिगॉइड वेनस प्लेक्सस दिखा दिया है, क्या है कि यू नो ये दिस इज द साइड बोन इज द बोनी स्कल, यू हैव रिमूव्स दिस जायगोमैटिक आर्च, डाउन बिलो यू फाइंड इज दिस लेटर, याद रखना देयर आर टू मसल्स मीडियल एंड लेटरल टेरिगॉइड. तो ये बार बार बात कर रहे हैं हम टेरिगॉइड वेनस प्लेक्सस की, दैट टेरिगॉइड वेनस प्लेक्सस, वी रिमेंबर सोलियस गैस्ट्रोसोलियस, that muscle is called a peripheral heart, yaad hai? So why is soleus called a peripheral heart? Because it pumps blood, the venous blood, towards the heart against gravity. Theek hai? So that's why soleus is a peripheral heart. If I ask that which other muscle acts as a peripheral heart, can you tell me? Which other muscle acts as a peripheral heart? Chunki humne yahan pe question, the question has arise just now, so common sense lagti hai. And there I am talking about, yaad rakhna, that lateral pterygoid. Yaad rakhna, it is not the medial pterygoid. It is lateral pterygoid. जो बाहर से हमें, जब हम बाहर से laterally approach कर रहे हैं, so deep, you know, medial pterygoid ये अंदर की तरफ है. But this is the lateral pterygoid. So याद रखना that lateral pterygoid muscle के बारे में अभी तुम्हें पढ़ाया जाएगा आगे के chapter में about the muscles of mastication, right? There are lots of muscle which help to open and close the mouth, and they help in mastication of food. But the main, the only muscle out of the four different muscles involved in mastication, the only muscle which helps to open the mouth is lateral pterygoid. One point with lateral pterygoid is that it helps in opening of the mouth. The other very important point is that it encloses in its substance the pterygoid venous plexus. So pterygoid venous plexus is found within the substance of lateral pterygoid. Got it? And of course, it's surrounded on its median lateral surface as well. Median lateral surface pit surrounded by pterygoid venous plexus. So, ab koi soche aur bataye, ye jo yawning hoti hai, have you seen yawning people sitting idle for 2-3 hours, not talking to anybody, right? Then they start yawning. Muh faad karke jamai lete hain. Shitij Parihar. Yawning करना स्टार्ट कर दिया. So yawning कब होती है? When you are not talking to anybody, you are sitting idle for 2-3 hours, तो फिर ये समस्या आती है. Okay? सही है, ऑफ कर दिया videos. तो लेटरल टेरिगॉइड, हाँ तो अब बात ये आ रही यॉनिंग क्यों होती है, यॉनिंग कब होती है, यॉनिंग इसलिए होती है, लुक हियर, जब इंसान बात करता है, कंटिन्यूसली बात करता है, बात नहीं करता है तो च्युइंगम खाता रहता है. तो व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हाइल च्युइंग और व्हाइल टॉकिंग और व्हाइल ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ऑफ द जॉ, यू आर एक्चुअली ओपनिंग दिस माउथ. सो व्हेन यू आर ओपनिंग द माउथ, yes yes Osama, you are reaching there, you're correct. So head and neck mein within the cranial cavity, you know, veins do not pulsate. So head and neck mein jo veins hai uska bahut sluggish flow hota hai cranial cavity mein. There within the dural venous sinuses wahan koi pulsations nahi ho rahe hote, theek hai? So that has a sluggish flow. So that venous, you know, that venous return from the head, from the cranial cavity, वो तुम्हें पता है ना, cavernous sinus से through emissary veins it drains into pterygoid venous plexus. So pterygoid venous plexus mein there is blood accumulated, they will squeeze out actually, you know, when lateral pterygoid contracts, your jaw opens, like your mouth opens. Lateral retrograde helps in opening the mouth, right? तो हम जब lateral retrograde contract करेंगे तो क्या होगा, jaw तो खुलेगा, मुंह खुलेगा, साथ साथ क्या होगा, the venous blood within this lateral pterygoid venous plexus squeezes and drains into the internal jugular. ठीक, यानी venous return to the right atrium कब होता है, when you are opening your mouth. तो इसलिए क्या होता है, जब इंसान बार बार मुंह नहीं खुलेगा तो there will be क्या हो जाएगा, acidosis, like collection of carbonic acids. So उसकी वजह से क्या होता है, respiratory centers stimulate होते हैं and this is a reflex phenomena when you sit idle. This because of collection of deoxygenated blood, it causes opening of the mouth, yawning हो जाती है. ठीक, तो ये कितनी सारी पॉइंट्स हमने लेटरल टेरिगॉइड से रिलेवेंट बता दिए हैं, होप यू विल रिमेम्बर दिस. नाउ यू सीइंग इज, यू नो, हम एक्सटर्नल जुगलर की बात कर रहे थे, ये अभी रूफ के कंटेंट्स में है. दिस एक्सटर्नल जुगलर वेन रनिंग, यू नो आई टोल्ड यू दैट मसल रन्स ऑब्लिकली, द वेन रन्स वर्टिकली ऑन द सब्सटेंस ऑफ दिस मसल. इसके ट्रिब्यूटरीज बहुत सारे थे, पोस्टियाकुलर वेन है तो ऊपर से खा रहे आ रही है, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट, बट यहाँ पे एक चीज दिख रही है, ये जुगुलर वेनस आर्च इसको कहते हैं. द टू एंटीरियर जुगुलर वेन्स, दीज आर द एंटीरियर जुगुलर वेन्स, द टू एंटीरियर जुगुलर वेन्स ज्वाइन टू फॉर्म अ वेनस आर्च एंड दिस वेनस आर्च लाइज इन द सुपरास्टर्नल स्पेस ऑफ बर्न. And if it's asked where is like the communication between external and internal jugular vein, to answer hai ye oblique jugular vein. So oblique jugular vein, yaad rakhna, oblique jugular vein communicates between external and internal jugular veins. Theek, ye dekho, posterior division of retromandibular, posterioricular together joined to form external jugular vein which runs vertically in the side of the neck over sternocleidomastoid down below. It receives tributaries from transverse cervical and suprascapular and further it pierces the deep fascia to drain into the subclavian vein. Tributaries of external jugular vein, ये हमने इसलिए कवर करा दिया है, ये roof में तो content है, ये posterior triangle में, but अलग से short note भी पूछा जा सकता है, otherwise you know MCQs तो है ही है. So external jugular vein में क्या क्या tributaries drain करती हैं, posterior external jugular vein, anterior jugular vein, ठीक है, posterior external jugular vein, anterior jugular vein, दो, transverse cervical and suprascapular vein. ये इसलिए बड़ा आसान था क्योंकि इनके साथ साथ nerves and arteries of the same vein parallel चलती हैं, ठीक, और oblique jugular vein बताया भी, that helps to communication with the internal jugular vein. Cutaneous nerves के बारे में we have discussed them all, ठीक, this is great auricular, this is lesser occipital. If it's asked which nerve ascends along the posterior border of sternocleidomastoid, the answer is lesser occipital nerve. Which nerve crosses transversely over to the sternocleidomastoid? It is transverse cervical or anterior cervical. Then you will see this is supra clavicular nerves. Ye pierce karke fir ye teen divisions mein divide hoti, medial, intermediate and lateral. Theek, okay, ye medial, acha ye batao, skin overlying manubrium sterni is by which nerve? Skin overlying manubrium sterni is innervated by which nerve? Medial supraclavicular nerve. ठीक. Now you see, यही एक transverse cervical इसकी बताई गई थी जो कि front of neck को serve करती है, but इसका जो lower extent है medial वाले transverse cervical का, वो जाएगी कहां तक? जाएगी suprasternal border तक की. ठीक है. As well as it will reach descend down to supply the skin of the front of manubrium. ठीक. Then floor of the posterior triangle की बात कर रहे हैं. The floor is formed by prevertebral or the deep cervical fascia covering the following muscles. यानी कि अगर floor खोलेंगे इसमें तो एक शीट होगी डी फाशा की, दैट्स कॉल्ड प्रीवर्टिब्रल फाशा. एंड इफ यू आर नॉट टचिंग द प्रीवर्टिब्रल फाशा, So the structures below to that, they will remain safe. So what are the structures underneath to this prevertebral fascia, which form the floor? They are splenius. From above, the splenius capitis, levator scapulae, isclenius medius, and isclenius posterior also seen sometimes occasionally. ठीक, तो ये देखो ये क्या है, फ्लोर है. बट फ्लोर में एक चीज तुम्हें दिख रही है कि ऑल दीज मसल्स इन द फ्लोर दे आर कवर्ड विद अ फाशा कॉल्ड प्री वर्टिब्रल फाशा. एंड द मसल्स फॉर्मिंग द फ्लोर आर एक्चुअली स्क्लेनियस एंटीरियर, स्क्लेनियस मीडियस, स्क्लेनियस पोस्टीरियर. ये स्क्लेनाई मसल्स है. देन यू हैव लीवेटर स्कैपुली, देन यू हैव स्प्लीनियस कैपिटिस. Sometimes, as I said, कि apex के level पे semi-spinal scapitis भी मिल सकती है. Okay? ये chart है, वैसे तो इसका screenshot ले सकते हो चाहो तो, otherwise it is given in your book. Contents of the posterior triangle पे details में दिया है. Contents of the posterior triangle, they have divided into a larger upper triangle called the occipital triangle and a lower smaller triangle, the subclavian triangle. There are nerves, there are vessels, there are lymph nodes in both the triangles. The important point is, yaad rakhna, pucha jaye, roots and trunks of brachial plexus are content of posterior triangle is correct. Agar pucha jaye choice mein posterior triangle to correct. Lekin to be more precise, agar isme divide karke poochte hain, that roots of the brachial plexus, trunks of the brachial plexus are seen in which triangle, occipital or subclavian? So remember, the important point is that the roots and trunks of brachial plexus are not seen in the occipital triangle. They are seen in the lower smaller triangle, yaad rakhna, in the subclavian triangle, as well as third part of subclavian artery. Third part of subclavian artery, yaad karo, which muscle divides subclavian artery into three parts? Yes, sclenius anterior. Good. So third part of sclenius anterior is a content of subclavian triangle. Okay. Yes, sclenius anterior divides this artery into three parts. Good. अब हम बात करते हैं sternocleidomastoid muscle. तुम देख चुके हो अच्छे से. I've told you about the cutaneous nerves, how they arise by piercing the prevertebral fascia initially, then they pierce the deep fascia to become cutaneous. All about these different four cutaneous nerves I have taught you. Then hum ab arteries ki baat karein isme. Theek hai, pehle hold on, is diagram mein contents pe hum chal rahe hain to idhar dhyan dete hain contents ke bare mein. Look here, now this is sclenius anterior. ये तो sternocleidomastoid का fleshy head है. But down below sclenius anterior or medius ke beech mein se, you will find these are the roots of brachial plexus coming out. They form the trunks. Thick. So they are the content of subclavian triangle. And if you remember, upper trunk of brachial plexus gives two branches, right? One is nerve to subclavius and the other is suprascapular nerve. And the point is called Erb's point. एक करेक्शन इज डायग्राम में, द करेक्शन इज दैट नर्व टू सबक्लेवियस जो दिख रही है, दिस डिसेंड्स डाउन एंटीरियरली टूवर्ड्स एंटीरियर टू द रूट्स और द ट्रंक्स ऑफ द ब्रेकियल प्लेक्सस, एंटीरियर टू द सबक्लेवियन वेसल्स, बट इट रन्स बिहाइंड दीज टू आर्टरीज. ये कौन सी होती है? ट्रांसवर सर्वाइकल आर्टरी, सुप्रास्कैपुलर आर्टरी. इसके डीप होती है. इन दिस डायग्राम दे हैव सीन दैट शोन दैट दिस नर्व इज एंटीरियर, सो दिस इज रॉन्ग. ओके, अब हम तुमको उसमें और क्या बता दें. स्क्रीनशॉट तो ले लिया होगा, बाकी चीजें डिटेल में तुम्हें हम पढ़ लेना. वेसल्स की बात करते हैं सबसे पहले. नर्व सप्लाई, हाँ, स्टर्नोक्लियोडोमास्टॉइड की नर्व सप्लाई कोई बता दे. व्हिच, व्हाट इज द नर्व सप्लाई स्टर्नोक्लियोडोमास्टॉइड? It is by spinal accessory nerve and this is a motor supply is by spinal accessory nerve. as proprioceptive sensory supply is by C2, C3, ventral division. These nerves are proprioceptive. Nerve supply is tunnel mesa. Now look here. Ye hum baat kar rahe hain blood supply. Blood supply iska neat PG mein question aa chuka hai. Regarding the blood supply of sternocleidomastoid. ठीक है, तो याद रखना इसका बड़ा आसान सा मैंने तरीका बना दिया है. यू हैव टू डिवाइड द मसल इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स, अपर वन थर्ड, मिडिल वन थर्ड, लोअर वन थर्ड. ठीक, सो ब्लड सप्लाई इज बाय फोर आर्टरीज, ये भी याद रखना. तो फोर आर्टरीज को कैसे याद रखना है, ऑस, ओ ओ एस एस, ऑस. ठीक है, ऑस वर्ड कई जगह पढ़ चुके हो तुम लोग. यूट्रस में होता है एक्सटर्नल ऑस, इंटरनल ऑस. ठीक है, ऑस ट्राइगोनम एक बोन होती है, पढ़ा है. ओके, तो ऑस, ऑस याद रखना. ये ऑस जो है याद रखना, तो इससे तुम्हें ब्लड सप्लाई याद रहेगी. दैट मींस अपर पोर्शन यानी कि अपर वन थर्ड में देर आर टू ब्रांचेस फ्रॉम ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी. ठीक, तो ये अपर वन थर्ड की सप्लाई हो गई, टू ब्रांचेस फ्रॉम ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी. मिडिल वन थर्ड की जो सप्लाई है दैट इज मोस्टली बाय सुपीरियर थायराइडल आर्टरी, मोस्टली. बट समटाइम्स इट कैन हैव अ डायरेक्ट ब्रांच फ्रॉम एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड आर्टरी से भी ब्रांच मिल सकती है इसको, और इट कैन हैव सप्लाई फ्रॉम बोथ सुपीरियर थायराइडल और एंड एक्सटर्नल जुगुलर, बोथ से हो सकती है. बट मोस्टली इट इज बाय सुपीरियर थायराइडल आर्टरी. Then the lower one third of this muscle is by suprascapular artery. ये दिख रही है suprascapular artery and transverse cervical. ये suprascapular artery जो है ये that supplies the lower one third of sternocleidomastoid. ठीक है, तो ये याद रखना OSS regarding the blood supply of sternocleidomastoid. ये diagram तुम्हें इसलिए दिखाया है वो confusion दूर हो जाएगा. Nerve to subclavius के बारे में, it arises from the upper trunk, then it descends down anterior to the roots and trunks of brachial plexus, anterior to subclavian vessels, but it runs behind the suprascapular and transverse cervical artery. Okay, ये you know contents of the posterior triangle है, spinal accessory nerve, ये सब तुम्हारे बारे में, I mean you know you can go and read them detail में, सब कुछ लिखा हुआ है. Spinal accessory nerve, although ये जो course है spinal accessory nerve का, that runs through a fascial tunnel, ठीक है, जो roof से attached होता है. Then there are cutaneous, four cutaneous branches, all I have told you. Muscular branches जो होती हैं इसके अंदर, यानी कि देर विल बी नर्व सप्लाइंग टू लिवेटर स्कैपुली एंड ट्रेपेजियस डायरेक्ट ब्रांचेस राइट फ्रॉम C3 C4 डायरेक्ट मस्कुलर ब्रांचेस विल बी गिवन टू ट्रेपेजियस एंड लिवेटर स्कैपुली. नर्व टू रोम्बोइडियस, नर्व टू रोम्बोइडियस इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ, कोई बता देगा, नर्व टू रोम्बोइडियस इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ, नर्व टू रोम्बोइडियस इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ root of C5, ठीक है, it arises from the root of C5, it is also called nerve to levator scapulae. Then is क्या कर रहे हो, चलने दो ना. Then nerve to serratus anterior, इसके बारे में पिछले लेक्चर में बताया था, it is also called nerve of bell. Then nerve to subclavius sometime, ये देखो बहुत important point आ गया यहाँ पे. क्या है कि phrenic nerve के बारे में you know you have been told that phrenic nerve arises from cervical plexus C3 C4 C5, right? ठीक है, और C4 का reference summit of shoulder से बताया था, referred pain के लिए, and it supplies the diaphragm and the fibrous pericardium. ठीक है, तो phrenic nerve तो ये हो गई थी. अब फ्रेनिक नर्व के साथ साथ एक एसेसरी फ्रेनिक नर्व होती, वो याद रखना भाई. एसेसरी फ्रेनिक नर्व इज एन ओकेजनल ब्रांच सीन टू बी अराइजिंग फ्रॉम सब नर्व टू सबक्लेवियस, एंड नर्व टू सबक्लेवियस जो होता है इसका रूट नंबर क्या होता है, C5 C6. ठीक है, तो नर्व टू सबक्लेवियस समटाइम्स गिव ऑफ एन एसेसरी फ्रेनिक नर्व. ये जो है ना, ये देखो यहां पे नर्व टू सबक्लेवियस है, तो इसी से एक ब्रांच अराइज होगी, राइट. This, you know, यहाँ पे they haven't shown there actually sternum and क्या नहीं, sclenius anterior. So nerve to subclavius gives out its branch occasionally called accessory phrenic nerve which will join the phrenic nerve. ठीक है, तो accessory phrenic nerve कल को कोई पूछे, it will be a branch of nerve to subclavius. Suprascapular nerve, ये भी बताया पर ट्रंक से निकलती, three trunks of brachial plexus, ये भी दिखेंगे subclavian triangle. Transverse cervical artery at the anterior border of the levator scapulae, it divides into superior and transverse cervical artery का role बहुत important है. If you see muscles of the back, तो muscles of the back में trapezius को हम हटाएंगे, then you will find उसके below कौन सी muscles दिखेंगी, second layer में levator scapulae, rhomboides minor and major, यानी कि there will be an artery running along the medial border of the scapula between first and second layer, and that will be the superficial branch of the transverse cervical artery. But if you dissect this levator scapulae, rhomboides minor and major, that means some second layer of the back agar dissect karenge, down below to that you will find deep branch of transverse cervical artery along with dorsal scapular nerve. ठीक है, जैसे nerve to rhomboides भी कहते हैं. तो ये जो deep branch है, ये किसमें anastomosis करती है, and the anastomosis on the dorsal back of scapula में participate करती है. ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी है, देखो ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी बिल्कुल एपेक्स ऑफ द ट्राइंगल में अराइज करती है. ठीक, सुप्रा स्कैपुलर आर्टरी दैट रन्स अलोंग द अपर बॉर्डर ऑफ द स्कैपुला एंड सप्लाइज द इट सप्लाइज द मसल्स ऑन द बैक ऑफ स्कैपुला. सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी तो मेजर आर्टरी है. ठीक है, it runs over the first rib. देखो एक्चुअली क्या है, ये ब्रेकियल प्लेक्सस है, इसलिए हमें दिखाया गया कंटेंट्स ऑफ सबक्लेवियन ट्राइंगल में क्या आता है. दे हैव गिवन इट इन डिफरेंट कलर कोड्स. इन द नेक इज दिस रीजन, रूट्स एंड ट्रंक्स एंड द डिविजन्स पार्टली दे आर सीन इन द साइड ऑफ द नेक, मींस पोस्टीरियर ट्राइंगल के कंटेंट है, और मूव टू बी मोर स्पेसिफिक इन सबक्लेवियन ट्राइंगल में. Then बताया था that divisions of the post brachial plexus run behind the clavicle, they are retroclavicular. So the green color code shows that this portion, ये सब MCQ बनते हैं, that divisions, where will you find the divisions of post brachial plexus, they will be lying behind the clavicle. What are the contents of axilla, they are actually the cords and branches of the brachial plexus, they are all seen as a content of axilla. ठीक, बाकी इसका स्क्रीनशॉट ले सकते हो. ये सारी चीजें थोड़ी थोड़ी सी मैंने ऐसे ऐसे यहाँ पे लिख रखी हैं. टाइम नहीं है टू कवर द मैप. तुम लोग परेशान हो गए बोर हो गए तो वैसे मैंने बताया था यू कैन हैव लाइक टी कॉफी साथ में रखा करो, क्योंकि काफी एक्सटेंसिव हो जाता है, रिविजन भी रहता है बीच बीच में. Now look here, ye, one of the contents, like you may have talking about the contents of this subclavian triangle. So, these are the roots and trunks of brachial plexus that are passing behind the clavicle. To kya bataya tha that pre-vertebral fascia ka modification hota hai, axillary sheath. Now axillary sheath invests this brachial plexus along with subclavian artery. Yaad rakhna, that subclavian vein lies outside the axillary sheath. So axillary artery ke contents dekh le. Now through this tunnel it reaches into the axilla. Ab ek aur important point ye hai, to diagram pehle dekhte hain, diagram kis baat mein hai. Diagram actually has been shown to show the drainage of the abscess, like there is a tubercular abscess or in the spine, or there be a chronic retropharyngeal abscess right behind the pharynx here. That abscess, when abscess starts dribbling or draining along this course of the brachial plexus through the axillary sheath, so you can find abscess in the posterior triangle. There will be a bulging or the swelling because of the lymphadenopathies there. Through the axillary sheath they can reach into the axilla. You can find lymph nodes there in the lateral wall of the axilla. So that's the course of the tubercular abscess, drainage of the abscess along the axillary sheath. Ek aur important point ye hai, kabhi kabar block dissection of these axillary lymph nodes hota hai. Axillary lymph nodes mein ke upar, if you remember lymphatic drainage of breast, bahut important topic tha. लिम्फेटिक ड्रेनेज ऑफ ब्रेस्ट में द लास्ट स्टेज वॉज लाइक यू नो पहले तो मोस्ट ऑफ द लिम्फेटिक ड्रेनेज गोज इन टू द एंटीरियर और द पेक्टोरल ग्रुप ऑफ लिम्फ नोड्स. ठीक. डीप पोर्शन ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट किस में ड्रेन करता है? अपाइकल में. अपर लिम किस में ड्रेन करता है? लेटरल में. ऑल ऑफ देम देन सेकेंडरी गोज इन टू द सेंट्रल ग्रुप. सेंट्रल से किस में जाता है? एपाइकल में. एपाइकल से किस में जाएगा? अल्टीमेटली इट विल क्रॉस द क्लेविकल एंड रीच टू सुप्रा क्लेविकुलर. उदय जैन यू करेक्ट. सुप्रा क्लेविकुलर लिम्फ नोड्स बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है एंड दे प्रेजेंट बोथ द साइड राइट एंड लेफ्ट. बट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट ये है कि यू नो दैट थोरैसिक डक्ट से ही लिम्फेटिक ड्रेनेज अल्टीमेटली रीचेस द सिस्टमिक सर्कुलेशन. नाउ That's why the left supraclavicular lymph nodes may बहुत important है. And you have a different name. Can anybody tell me the another name for left supraclavicular group of lymph nodes? They are also called left supraclavicular group of lymph nodes are also called Virchow's node. Virchow's V-I-R-C-H-O-W-S Virchow's node. ठीक है. तो क्या होता है कि इसमें जब यू नो विरकाउज नोड में आई मीन यू नो लेफ्ट साइड में बट राइट साइड में भी हो सकता है. दो क्या होता है लिम्फेडिनोपैथी अगर सुप्रा क्लेविकुलर लिम्फ नोड में हो गए दैट मींस इट रीचेस द लास्ट आई मीन यू नो लेटर स्टेज ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट कैंसर या लंग कैंसर या लिम्फोमा नॉन हॉजकिंस हॉजकिंस लिम्फोमा इसमें भी लिम्फेडिनोपैथी होती है. तो In cases, especially in the lung and breast cancer, mein, there is a word used, block dissection. Block dissection mein kya hota hai ki jo tumor hai, that has to be excised, mastectomy karni pad sakti hai. Along with the axillary and supraclavicular lymph nodes have to be removed. Ye clinical points hai, tumhe likhna padega ye sab cheezein. So contents, ab jahan hum remove karenge, we'll reach here while dissecting out the axillary lymph nodes and the supraclavicular lymph nodes. You will have to be cautious enough, you know, agar lymphadenopathy hum remove kar rahe hain, block dissection kar rahe hain, to ye nerve, supra, subclavian artery, ye sab bhi cheezi hai na damage honge. To maine starting mein bataya tha, all these are laminated under a deep fascia called prevertebral fascia. To agar hum prevertebral fascia ko touch nahi karte hain, Remember, all these structures lie below the floor of the posterior triangle or the subclavian triangle, covered by prevertebral fascia. Okay, so they are safe if you are not incising the prevertebral fascia. इसके बारे में भी क्या one of the you know modifications of the fascia में ये इसलिए आ रहे बता रहे हैं ये one of the deep structures of the posterior triangle below to the sternocleidomastoid में आती है ये carotid sheath. Contents of carotid sheath बहुत important है इसलिए इसमें याद रखना कि first of all this is anterior this is posterior medial most medial content क्या होता है तो याद रखना medial is artery lateral is vein बहुत important है vein is lateral artery is medial you can say artery has a more of protection lying you know medial in the neck medial means something which is deep in the neck तो ये मीडियल होगी वेन विल बी इंटरजुगुलर वेन विल बी लेटरल. अब आती है एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर. अनदर कंटेंट इज वेगस नर्व. तो याद रखना वी वेगस नर्व विल बी पोस्टीरियरली प्लेस्ड. ठीक. आउटसाइड टू द कैरोटिड शीथ क्या होता है आगे की तरफ यू नो एंसर सर्वाइकल इज एक्चुअली इट्स अ लूप ऑफ यू नो क्रेनियल पार्ट ऑफ एसेसरी विद यू नो हाइपोग्लॉसल और यहाँ पे इसमें C1 C2 इन्वॉल्व होते हैं तो दे फॉर्म द एंसर सर्वाइकलिस इज अ लूप ऑफ नर्व व्हिच सप्लाइज द सुप्राहायड ग्रुप ऑफ मसल्स. तो ये एंसर सर्वाइकलिस इज एम्बेडेड टू द एंटीरियर सरफेस ऑफ कैरोटिड शीथ. याद रखना ए फॉर एंटीरियर ए फॉर एंसर सर्वाइकलिस. ठीक. What lies posterior? तो sympathetic trunk. Confusion नहीं होना चाहिए. Sympathetic ये actually NEET PG में question आ चुका है regarding the relation of posterior sympathetic trunk. तो sympathetic trunk lies posterior to the carotid sheath. Ansa cervicalis lies anterior to the carotid sheath. A for anterior, A for ansa cervicalis. इसके अलावा deep lymph nodes of the neck they are all lying along the स्पाइनल एसेसरी नर्व. नाउ स्पाइनल एसेसरी नर्व के बारे में बता दें कि स्पाइनल एसेसरी नर्व जो होती है ये इसका क्रेनियल रूट होता है कि स्पाइनल रूट. स्पाइनल एसेसरी नर्व की बात हो रही है तो स्पाइनल रूट की बात हो रही है. तो स्पाइनल रूट क्या है ये स्टर्नोक्लिडोमास्टॉइड है. इसका एंटीरियर बॉर्डर ये पोस्टीरियर बॉर्डर. एंटीरियर बॉर्डर में अपर 1/4 एंड लोअर 3/4 के जंक्शन पे this spinal accessory nerve pierces sternocleidomastoid, yani ki it pierces and supplies this muscle. Then it emerges in the posterior triangle somewhere just above the midpoint on the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid by piercing this muscle. Now when it emerges out, bahar aati hai ye spinal accessory nerve, so this you will find is embedded within, embedded with a fascia around it, and that fascia is embedded to the roof of the posterior triangle, roof of the posterior triangle. So yani ki jo skin flap hai uske niche jo yani ki deep fascia, yani ki investing layer of the deep cervical fascia mein ek टनल बनती है, जैसे एक बताया था टनल फॉर ओमोहाइड थी, ठीक है, तो टनल इसकी भी होती है, यानी कि जिसको कोर्स स्पाइनल एसेसरी का दैट्स रनिंग थ्रू अ टनल, यहाँ पे दिखाया ये टनल बन रही है, ये टनल किससे बनती है, बाय द इन्वेस्टिंग लेयर ऑफ द डी सर्वाइकल फाशा, दैट फाशा फ्रॉम द रूफ ऑफ द पोस्टर ट्राइंगल, उसके थ्रू पास होती है. फिर क्या करेगी ये नर्व, क्योंकि ये भी इसको ट्रेपीजियस को भी सप्लाई करना है, देन इट रीचेस द एंटीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ द ट्रेपीजियस around 5 cm above the clavicle, it passes deep to the trapezius to supply trapezius on its inner surface. Theek? This is how the course of spinal accessory nerve is. You can see it pierces, it is, now this is intramuscular course, don't get confused, it does not runs behind sternocleidomastoid, it runs within sternocleidomastoid, got it? It pierces the muscle and just above the midpoint on the posterior border, it emerges, courses through this posterior triangle within the fascial tunnel and then passes below to the trapezius 5 cm above the clavicle. अब इसमें क्या है कुछ क्लिनिकल पॉइंट्स में, यहाँ पे चूंकि वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द साइड ऑफ द नेक, तो सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्ट्रक्चर है, सबक्लेवियन ट्राइंगल में भी, तो सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी यू नो इट आर्चेस ओवर द फर्स्ट ट्रिप एंड यू नो दैट देयर इज दिस स्क्लेनाइड ट्यूबरकल ऑन टू विच दिस मसल इज क्लेनियस एंटीरियर. नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस क्लेनियस एंटीरियर सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी इज डिवाइड इनटू फर्स्ट सेकंड एंड थर्ड पार्ट, राइट, द थर्ड पार्ट इज अ कंटेंट ऑफ सबक्लेवियन ट्राइंगल. Now the anomalies associated with this is this clinius anterior, in case sometimes is there's a short muscle, if it's a short muscle it will have a compressing effect on the subclavian artery, or it might have a bifided insertion, yani jab bifided insertion hoga to ek gap reh jayega, so that will compress the artery. Teesri cheez ho sakti hai, the third reason might be सर्वाइकल रिब. इफ यू फाइंड अ सर्वाइकल रिब, तो सर्वाइकल रिब विल बी रनिंग अबव द फर्स्ट ट्रिप, सो दैट ऑल्सो विल कंप्रेस द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी. सो देयर आर दीज रीजंस, यू नो, डिफरेंट रीजंस ऑफ थोरैसिक आउटलेट सिंड्रोम, बिकॉज ऑफ विच देयर विल बी नैरोइंग ऑफ द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी, और नैरोइंग ऑफ द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी विल हैम्पर द ब्लड सप्लाई टू द अपर लिम. ठीक, और इस कंडीशन में होगा क्या फिर, चूंकि सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी हैम्पर हो गई है, तो फिर देयर विल बी एनास्टमोसिस फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ सबक्लेवियन टू द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ एक्सिलरी आर्टरी, क्योंकि ये कंप्रेस होगी तो एक्सिलरी आर्टरी में ब्लड कम जाएगा, गॉट इट? तो फिर इसको ओवरकम कैसे करेंगे, फर्स्ट पार्ट से बाईपास दे देंगे, किसमें, थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ एक्सिलरी में, और वो बाईपास किसके क्या कहते हैं, एनास्टमोसिस ऑन द बैक ऑफ स्कैपुला. समटाइम्स यू नो यही सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी ईसोफेगस के अराउंड जाती है, एबनॉर्मल सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी, एंड दैट कंप्रेसेस द ईसोफेगस एंड दैट कॉजेस डिस्फेजिया लुसोरिया. याद रखना, डिस्फेजिया लुसोरिया इज ड्यू टू एबनॉर्मल सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी कंप्रेसिंग द ईसोफेगस. ठीक, चलो हो गया है, कुछ लोग बोर हो चुके हैं बहुत देर से सुनते सुनते, टाइम इज इनफ. और स्टर्नोक्लीडोमास्टॉइड रह गया है, ऑल द मोस्ट ऑफ इट हैज बीन कवर्ड इन माय लेक्चर, फिर भी इफ आई गेट टाइम सम टाइम आई विल कवर इट लेटर ऑन. ओके, थैंक यू.